Welcome to the Nightly Rant
with your hosts,
Mike
and Torya.
This is the show where we examine society from a sarcastic point of view.
If you like insane conversations, this is definitely the show for you.
Let's get into today's topic. YPN people, I don't know about you, but I love helping out a friend. That's why I want to shout out my friend Brian Little and his podcast, Your Favorite Blockhead. This is the only show that manages to weave together peanuts and MMA into one heck of an amazing podcast. You can find Your Favorite Blockhead wherever your favorite podcasts reside and at yourfavoriteblockhead.com. Do me a huge favor and listen to Brian's show. You'll be entertained and you'll help out a friend. Now, as I said, let's get into today's topic. So last night, I was in bed and I had been reading something, and on Twitter, they were talking about, there was like a hashtag that was trending about the Atlanta police walking out. And I thought police contracts don't allow that.
Police department walking out?
Yes, because as people know, by the time you hear this, the police officers in Atlanta that were involved in the Rayshard killing, they have been charged in criminal court. And the police officers don't like it because apparently, like, their equivalent of the internal affairs is something called, like, BGI. They hadn't even finished their investigation. And apparently in their contract or something, or maybe it's just our right, I'm not sure which, and I could be confused by this because I just sort of heard it on the news in passing, and I haven't had time to research it yet. But they also have the right to go before a grand jury and have the grand jury hear the evidence and then decide whether to indict them or not. And they didn't do any of that. And they go and announce charges. Oh, and by the way, one of the things they're trying to say is that he kicked the dead body. So they took a picture, didn't show a video, showed a picture of him with his knee bent. And like people are saying, how do we know he wasn't just going and stepping over him?
People bend their knees just walking.
Yeah, it's the stupidest thing. And there's a reason why they're not showing the video to that. So the response that I heard was that they were walking off the job. And I was reading things and, you know, Atlanta PD denies that officers are, you know, walking off the job, says there's a higher instance of call-outs. And I'm like, well, isn't that the same thing? Like, if I'm going to not go to work, it doesn't matter how I don't go to work, I'm not going to work. So I go and I have the scanner app on my phone, which around here is virtually useless because none of the police stations reveal it because of that stupid California law that protects them.
Long Beach does.
Yeah, who cares?
I was listening to the Long Beach scanner the night when the protesters were going towards the aquarium because I wanted to know if they were
okay. But I listened, and there's two channels for Atlanta, and they happen to be two of the zones where people were walking out.
Mm-hmm.
Dead silent for 30 minutes. Nothing. And then you hear the dispatcher, hello? Is anyone there? Hello? Is anyone there? Hello? How bad is that? Like, no cops. But across the country, police officers are saying, okay, you think we're useless and we don't help and that you can do better without us? There, have at it. Try.
You know who I think is next? I think the LAPD is next. You want to know why I think they're next?
Sure, why?
Because they've been told that all that overtime they worked with the protests, that they're not going to be paid for any of it. They're just going to get time in lieu. So what better time than right now to take their time in lieu?
What I didn't understand was I saw there was one LAPD officer, and I triple-checked this number. It said that he was angry because during that all of the protests, he earned in overtime $40 million in overtime. How? That had to be a mistake. It must be $40,000. And even that's a lot, but I could see it with what they get paid per hour times time and a half times however many hours they put in. I could see it.
It had to be $40,000 because $40,000 I could wrap my head around, but $40 million doesn't make any sense.
If it's $40 million, there's something wrong. No wonder they get too much money.
Right.
But
well, because I would get the $40,000 because they're getting extra pay because of the hazardous situation that they're in, and they're getting extra pay for the hours over their regular 40 a week that they're working. And at some point,
it goes to double,
and then I think at some point too, it goes to triple.
No, there's no triple time in California. There's no triple time in California. Just double time. That's your max. You could get 80 hours of double time. It's just double time. But what are your thoughts on that about, you know, them calling out sick?
Go them.
Okay, and then what are your thoughts on the whole commentary that, all right, you guys think that we're useless and do no good, so here, have at it. Try without us.
I think that if one side of the issue is allowed to protest and yell their side at everybody who will listen, that the other side should be allowed to protest and yell their side at anyone who will listen. Well, I'm not going to say which side I agree with.
Here's the thing. I'm with you because here's what I think, okay? We're founded on a principle of having the freedom to speak, right? But we're also founded on the principle that we're allowed to defend ourselves and we're allowed to face up to our accuser, right? That's a right we have. We're allowed to do that. And that's how it is in most civilized countries. Makes sense. You can face your accuser. Well, it does make sense.
Are there exceptions to the face your accuser rule?
What do you mean?
Like, do you always, in every situation, have the right to face who's accusing you?
Yes.
Interesting. Okay. I was just curious.
So, why shouldn't they be allowed to present their side of the case?
They should be able to. And if this is how they need to do it, then I think that if we're respecting everyone else's right to protest, we need to respect theirs.
I agree with you there. And I also agree with you that I'm not taking sides on this.
Nope, not even one side.
I just think, you know what? It's okay for the protesters to protest and call attention to this. But it's also okay for the police to, in a sense, protest and call attention to their side of the story. It just makes sense to me.
Yep. And I think that it's going to have some very interesting, I hate to say consequences because it's not going to necessarily be bad, but consequences is the only word I can think of. They might be positive consequences.
What kind of consequences?
I just think that there are going to be some major impacts on things. I don't know what they are, but I think there's going to be some ripples.
I think there'll be an increase in crime.
I think so too. And that's really scary.
I think, okay, you know me, I'm objective. I try to look at all sides of the issue. And again, I have not come to any conclusion about which side I support, but I will say this. The one place where the get rid of the police people are missing the point completely is they don't think about the impact of having the police patrolling out in the street, okay? It's not just, oh, I have someone burglarized my mailbox, so I'm going to call the police and file a police report and have him investigate. That's part of their job, but a bigger part of their job is driving around. And I can tell you, I've been on multiple ride-alongs, and the last one I went on, she really liked going after stolen cars. And the police department she worked for had like a contest that if you could get this many, you'd get this prize. If you could get this many, you get this prize. It's like they reward them for finding stolen cars. So that was her goal in life. Find stolen cars.
You know what is interesting? If you had a prize for finding the most DUIs or the most, like, which is kind of crazy because you would think that that would cause some kind of corruption, but stolen cars are stolen cars. You can't fake a stolen car. Yeah. It's not physically possible.
Yeah.
Unless you stole the car.
Well, but have you ever noticed that the DUI person is not usually the officer that pulls them over?
No.
Usually there's one person on shift that knows how to do the DUI test because it's expensive to put them through the program. Else? So, you know, Officer Bree pulls me over, thinks I'm drunk, thinks I show signs, calls you, and you're the DUI officer, and then you put me through the sobriety check.
Interesting.
So there's kind of checks and balances there, but it still could be corrupted, but there's checks and balances there. And like I said, not going to say I can see the police side right now. I can see the protester side right now.
But I think the LAPD is next.
But I think that what will happen is the crime's going to go up because they're going to know there's no police officers patrolling the street. And like that's one of the things like why I've read many times like, oh, I waited until the officer went by and I had timed that it was going to take him 7 minutes and 13 seconds to loop back around and come back by watching him night after night for like a month. And then I ran inside that 7-Eleven and I robbed them. Yeah, they case the place, and they know, you know, if they're a criminal, they're going to case the place. They're going to know how long the police take. Well, if they don't have to even worry about the police, they don't have to case the place. They'll just go in there and rob it every night.
Right. I would be very concerned if I had a home or a business in Atlanta right now.
And then what do you think is going to happen? The business owners are going to be armed, and someone's going to get their head blown off. And then they're going to be screaming that that person shouldn't have been killed.
I think multiple someones are going to get their heads blown off.
But then they're going to be screaming that that person shouldn't have been killed. And that's the thing. Think your ideas through to the bitter end. You know,
they can't. It's not.
They
possible.
Purposely set up Black Lives Matters so that it's not technically a centralized organization. It's like splinter groups all over the place. But to me, I said, how well does that work for people? Oh, well, you know, ISIS does that rather successfully. Oh, really? You think ISIS is successful?
Well, hold up. We're comparing Black Lives Matter to ISIS.
Because that's what someone said. I'm not comparing it. That's what someone said. I said,
know you're not.
I said an organization has to be organized. It's why it's called an organization.
Someone who is pro Black Lives Matters should probably not compare it to ISIS. Pick something terrorist.
I'm not a fan of that organization, though. The movement makes sense, but the organization, not so much so.
Pick something less terrorist. If you're positive Black Lives Matter, because that's a really poor life decision.
Well, yeah, I agree, because that's just, it's a weird thing to compare yourself to. You know, I accidentally killed her, but let me compare myself to a mass murderer.
So if the LAPD is next, I think most of Southern California will follow the LAPD.
So you think like Orange County sheriffs will go, LA County sheriffs will go, then you think the small police departments will do it too?
Yes. I do, actually.
That's scary.
Yes, it really is. What I think is particularly alarming is how close we are to Long Beach.
Yeah.
And they will definitely follow LA, and all the scary people will flock.
Well, I don't necessarily agree with that, because, you know, where we live is one city, and then one city over is Long Beach. Why would the criminals in a place where there are no police come to a city where there are police?
I don't know that the criminals are smart enough to know where the boundaries are.
No.
I don't know where the boundaries are half the time.
If they're not smart enough to know where the boundaries are, they wouldn't be smart enough to know to go out and steal because there's no police. Let's be real here. Like, that's just the truth.
But yeah, I agree with you that there's going to be an increase in crime. And I think that there will be an increase in violent crime. And if people were, I don't know, aware of the huge increase in domestic violence during the quarantine, just imagine what's going to happen now that the domestic violence victims don't have the ability to call the police.
That, and rapists on the street.
Yeah.
And vigilante justice. I don't like that you hurt my daughter, so I'm going to go there. You know, you tried to rape my daughter. I'm going to go there and chop your penis off.
Yep.
Like, that's so the kind of stuff that's going to happen.
Hospitals will get busier.
Because
crimes
remember,
increase. And there won't be anybody to arrest the people committing the crime.
And remember, people always say the same bull crap. Criminals will be criminals and they will commit crimes. Yes, they will. But then there's those people who, if they know they could get away with it, would
They'll
try
do
it.
It.
But if they think there's even a 0.00000001% chance of getting caught, they're not going there. And so the police act as a deterrent to that.
Especially with the desperation some people are feeling due to the pandemic.
Yeah, people
this
who have,
is just like,
it's just a bad prescription here with people who've had too much time on their hands and not enough money.
You know how they talk about World War I starting and there was all of these things that were pissing everybody off, and then that dude got assassinated and bam, it was World War I because he was the like
right
final pow.
Right.
And it was like a powder keg waiting to be blown up. That's what's happening right now. This is all the little incidents causing the powder keg, and something terrible is going to happen, and there's going to be something alarming after that.
I hate being right, but I don't know if you remember, at least two years ago, I said there was going to be a civil war.
Here it is.
Here it comes.
Canada's looking pretty good right
here
now.
Here it comes. I don't know, man. You know, remind me to talk to you about something when we're off the air, because I don't want to bore the listeners, but, you know, that tells me that things are only going to get worse before they get better.
Did you expect any different?
Not really, but
let's
you know.
Take a minute and learn from history, people. The thing that I consistently say all the time, why is history there? For everybody to learn from.
You mean we shouldn't erase certain people from history books because they were racist, and we shouldn't knock their statues down because they're racist? Really? We shouldn't do that?
That's a topic for an entirely different day.
Yeah.
Because I have at least 100 minutes of words to say about that.
Let's do that in the next episode, because that's irritating.
Deal. Well, since we're going to save that for the next episode, then I have nothing else to say about the police issue. Good night, everyone.
Hasta la bye bye.
Thank you for listening to The Nightly Rant.
If you enjoyed the show, please give us a 5-star rating on Apple Podcasts or Google Play.
If you didn't enjoy the show, please just ignore that previous request for a rating.
This has been a Yogi's Podcast Network production.